You give me that recipe or I'll raise your rent higher than Georgia Pine.
Bro, there ain't no Texans ever gonna give you his barbecue recipe. That's a fact. He'd take you to his grave.
I could be bleeding like a stuck pig. I ain't gonna tell you.
We'll see about that.
Hello, this is Robert Rodriguez here for another 10-minute cooking school. Texas barbecue. I'll be showing you how to make real Texas award-winning barbecue, along with some sauce.
Goddamn sauce.
Now we're gonna get to the whole sauce controversy, but first let's start with the meat controversy. It's a lot of bitching and moaning in general when it comes to Texas barbecue, and that's a testament to people's passion for it. People go apeshit crazy over great Texas barbecue, and there's really no topping.
I know it sounds a little arrogant putting up a sign, best damn barbecue in Texas. Who's gonna come in here and argue about that?
So today we're not making those wimp-ass pork ribs that try and pass themselves off as barbecue. No, we're going for Texas beef ribs. I mean, these suckers are mean. Don't go get no short ribs either. You want to get the store's butcher to cut you some chuck beef ribs. Chuck ribs are from under the shoulder. There's a lot more meat. And if your butcher whines that he can't get it, go over his head and order it from somewhere online. Once you've got your supply, you can cut out that middleman. I'm particular about this sort of thing because my granddad was a rancher and he had a famous butcher shop down in Rio Grande City. So I grew up around slabs of hanging carcasses and saw how this stuff was done proper.
What's that meat?
So for your brisket, you want a well-marbled slab. I use Excel brand brisket because that's readily available. First, you want to keep it under 9 pounds, especially with smaller pits. This brisket here is about 6 or 7 pounds. The beef ribs should be good to go, but the brisket needs a little bit of trimming. You have two sides. One side has most of the fat. That's the top, because you want the fat dripping down. So let's start with the bottom side. Trim it so it looks like this. You want to keep this heel of fat over here. That's good. On the sides coming up from that, though, you want to trim the fat away, letting you see how marbled it is in there. Now, this third here is the lean section. And this two-thirds section over here, that's the money. That's where the fat is. That's where the taste is. That's where the flavor is. If you want to make great barbecue, you have to slow down. Brisket is going to cook for about an hour per pound, so keep those icy chango beers handy. Here we've got a smoker. Smaller pits just don't have big enough fireboxes, and fire management is key. The fire is in a separate box, and the indirect heat and the smoke goes into the main cooking area and slow cooks the meat. So what about temperature? That's what everyone always wants to know. How hot should the temperatures be?
You cook that meat at 250 degrees, don't you?
I don't remember. I set the heat with my hand.
You want your left side chamber where your brisket's gonna be, no lower than 275, no higher than 325. The right side chamber is where you would put your ribs in a pot of sauce, and that would go as high as 325. The firebox itself is gonna be pretty hot in there. It's gonna be about 500. For seasoning, put plenty, and I mean plenty of black pepper and salt, and coat the meat. I use 16 mesh black pepper with table salt, about a 90 to 10 ratio. That's 90% pepper, 10% salt. It's not a dusting. It's literally a rubbing. You want to get it all in there. Pieces of the meat will flake up and you want to make sure you get it in all the crevices. You want to make sure you rub it all along four sides and on the bottom. Nice thick layer all over. The brisket won't flake up as much as the ribs, but where it does, get it all in there. Anywhere it's naked. You gotta love that brisket if you want it to love you back. Coat it all over. Rub it in there. You can get fancy with a bunch of seasonings, but if you really want to accent the meat, and not lose anybody who's gonna be eating this, you wanna go basic. You don't wanna turn off a segment of your tasters right off the bat with your seasonings. Wait a few swigs, and then it's ready to put on the fire. When you put the brisket in, you wanna put it fat side up and fat side facing the heat. The beef ribs you're gonna put in closest to the fire, meat side up. Fire management means you're gonna have to check this every 20 minutes. Because once you see that bottom layer of logs crash down, you're gonna have to add another log on top to keep that heat consistent. There's many types of wood people use. It varies, but not for reasons you'd think. It's really an issue of abundance. In East Texas, it's hickory, which goes straight to the south. Further west, it's mesquite. However, oak is the sacred tree. Unfortunately, around these parts of Austin, Texas, we have an abundance of hill country oak. And that gives our barbecue a leg up. So if you can get oak, use oak. So the way you would time it is, if you're gonna do a 5 or 6 pound brisket, and that's gonna go in for 5 or 6 hours, you wanna put the ribs in later, because that's only gonna take about an hour and a half. So while it's cooking, you wanna hang close, you can manage that fire. Just chill out, take it low and slow. Now here's a trick to know when it's done. Press your finger on it, and it goes to the knuckle or a little above the knuckle, it's done. So for the ribs, we'll pull away from the edges of the bone on the sides like this, but it will actually puff up here. So press on it. It should be spongy, firm, not rubbery. And if you press a little harder, you should break right through it. Okay, so once it's done cooking, you want to wrap the meat in waxed butcher paper. You double it like this, have it overlapping, lay it on there, wrap it up, do the same for the ribs. Now what you want to do is put it back in the pit for another couple of hours. Do not use tin foil.
I don't use no goddamn foil.
Conducts too much heat and it will cause more evaporation and dry it out. Some places, and a lot of people will tell you this, a great brisket cooked right needs no sauce at all. And that's their testament to the great meat they provide. Now, this is an award-winning brisket that can stand on its own, but for kicks, we'll throw in some sauce, just an accent, along with a special secret recipe touch I will reveal today as my thanks to you for watching.
Holy shit, I think I finally cracked it.
For the sauce, I have a 6.5-quart pot. You want to add water till it's 3/4 full. Three cups of ketchup. Full thing of pepper, grab of salt versus a pinch of salt, grab of salt. 4 cups of beef stock or beef bouillon. 2 scoops of onions, 1/4 pound of butter. Now for the secret ingredient. That's right, a bottle of my own special brew of Chango beer. If you can't get that, you can substitute something else, but this is the secret. And then you want to let it cook in there for a couple of hours on the hot side. Barbecue is best with just plain white sandwich bread. It's a great tradition that should never die out. Now it's all done.
Mm. Oh man.
God damn, that's good.
Cut the lean section, and then take the fatty section and cut right down the middle. And to make slices, just slice straight down. Juicy, moist, delicious. This is the money piece right here. Drop it in a piece of bread, slap some sauce, or like I'm doing here, no sauce needed, should be juicy enough to eat right on its own. Damn, that's good. That's all you need right here. Texas BBQ. Anytime, anywhere.
You just remember, you got to take this recipe to your grave.
I think I can goddamn guarantee that.
Give it a try. Always remember, not knowing how to cook is like not knowing how to fuck. See y'all.